In this presentation, we will enter an adjusting entry or look at the problem related to an adjusting entry for accounts receivable or revenue. That problem being that we have an invoice that has been entered after the cutoff date, after the end of the month, for which the work was done before the cutoff date, before the end of the month. This is a typical kind of thing that can happen in, let's say, like a job costing type of system where we have to basically count the hours and then populate the invoice based on those number of hours. It may well be the case then that the work was done before we issue the invoice, and therefore on an accrual basis, we would really need to pull that income back in to the current period. Let's get started with Sage 50 Cloud Accounting. Here we are in our Get Great Guitars file. We're going to start off by opening up our financial statements. So we're going to go to the reports drop down. We're going to be opening up the financial statement reports. Let's start off with that balance sheet report, opening up that balance sheet report. We're going to be having the date for the second period. That's going to be February. So we're going to be keeping it there, February. And this is going to be our balance sheet. Now, what we're going to have in this kind of problem, this kind of adjusting entry type of problem, is a situation where we have an invoice that was entered, but it was entered after the cutoff date. And this might be easier to see on the income statement side. So let's open up the income statement side of things as well. So I'm going to go back to the reports, going into the income statement, and we'll open up for February as well. I'm going to remove the zero balances. So we will remove the zero balances, and there we have it. So when we think about the income statement, note that usually the income on an accrual basis is going to be generated in an accounting system by some type of form, some type of document, that typically being an invoice or a sales receipt. But in the case of an invoice, that would be a sale where we didn't collect revenue yet. So that would be the earliest point in time that you would typically have something that's going to be recorded as income, is when an invoice is created. Right, and that's before even cash was put in place. And on an accrual basis method, you would think that the invoice would be pretty close to the time the work was actually done. But notice that in practice, it may well be the case that the invoice was actually entered in some point after the work was done. For example, if we entered the invoice as of February, or if we did the work as of February 29th, or for the week ended, we may not gather that information and then create the invoice for it until sometime after February. So just note that the form then of the invoice is not, in that case, the most accurate accrual basis type thing to use. It's just the only thing that we have in the system to use. So I mean, what else are you gonna do? We need it. We need something to record it in the system. The invoice is the closest thing. If we hadn't entered the invoice until after the cutoff date, or if we entered the invoice after the work was done, then we still have a timing difference in terms of when the work should have been entered into the system. So that's going to be our problem here. We're going to want to say that the invoice was entered after the cutoff date. So let's say that we had to gather work or something like that, and the invoice was entered after February 29th, but the work was done before February 29th, and therefore we need to bring that income on an accrual basis back into the month in which it was actually done. So that's going to be the problem. I think it's most easily seen with something like a billable thing, like a law firm or a bookkeeping firm, where you have to basically track the hours of people and have billable hours, and that could be easy to see why the invoice wasn't created till after the cutoff. However, we want to do this with inventory just to make things a little bit more complicated. So when is the work done with, and why? Because it has inventory and cost of goods sold and sales tax to deal with. Therefore, the adjusting entry will be more difficult. But for inventory, when is the work done? Typically when you ship the goods, when the goods have been shipped out, that's typically when the work is going to be done. Now we're going to imagine a situation where, for whatever reason, the goods were shipped out before February, but the billing process didn't happen. The invoice didn't go out until after February. So the billing process, for some reason, happens after the amount, the items were shipped. Well, in that case, you have the same kind of situation. You need to pull the income back into the time period in which the work was done, and that's going to be before February. So to consider this more fully, we're going to actually enter the invoice. Now, I'm going to enter an invoice as of February, and we're imagining that this is going to be the invoice, it's going to be in March, right, that we're going to have to pull back into February with an adjusting journal entry, and then in the next presentation, we'll actually do that adjusting journal entry. So now all we're going to do is make an invoice over here. I'm going to go back on over, close this out. I don't know why that's there. I'm going to go back onto the first tab here. We're going to go into the customers and sales, and we're just going to make an invoice. So I'm going to say, all right, this is going to be an invoice, new invoice, and I'm going to make this for our first customer. Let's pick that customer up top. Let's just say Anderson is going to be the person for which the invoice is being made. And we're going to say the invoice is dated in March. So let's say it went into place in like March 6th, even though the work was done before February. So we didn't get around to invoicing until after the work was done. The revenue should be recorded in February according to an accrual basis, although the invoice wasn't entered until March. Okay, so now we're going to say there's one ELP, Epiphone Les Paul, and we will be applying the sales tax to it. So we'll say that has the sales tax on it. Now this is just a typical invoice. What's going to happen with this invoice? It's going to be increasing the accounts receivable by $547.50. It's going to be increasing revenue by $500. It's going to be increasing the taxes payable by $47.50. It will also be decreasing the inventory by an amount that's not on here, but we know what it is because we've seen the ELP quite often. That's going to be $400. And then the other is going to go to cost of goods sold. The only thing that's new here is this is going to be done after the cutoff date, and we're going to need to pull it in before the cutoff date with an adjusting entry. So let's go ahead and say save, and then just check out what has happened. I'm going to close this back out, and then let's go back to our income statement. So let's go into our income statement here. Here's the that's the balance sheet. That's the balance sheet. I want the income. There's the income statement. So then we're going to go to the COG up top, and I'm going to change the date to the date range we just entered that as of, which is going to be in March. So let's bring this on out to March, like so. And so there we have our typical invoice on the revenue side, right? We've got the income of the 500. So there's the 500 for the income. And then the cost of goods sold is going to be this 400. And the difference between the two is the net effect on the income statement. The other side on the balance sheet, of course. So if we go back on over to the balance sheet, changing the dates for the balance sheet to bring it out to March once again, we're going to say I need the date range, bringing that out into March. So I'm going to go March and okay. So now we have the accounts receivable should be going up. Accounts receivable going up now by the $547.50. And then we also know the inventory is going to be going down. Inventory is going down by the $400. This is all the effect of that one invoice. And then the sales tax payable. Sales tax payable also affected by the $47.50. Okay, so all of that happened after the cutoff date. Our objective is to say now that needs to be pulled back into the prior time period. In other words, it's easiest to see in the timing statement, the revenue statement, back to the income statement. This $500 revenue recognized in March needs to be recognized. I mean, in March here needs to be pulled back and recognized in February. So we need to pull that back into February with an adjusting journal entry. Now you might say, we're going to do that with just a journal entry. You might say, hey, well, what if we do that with a journal entry, then by the time we get back out here to March 31st, it'll be in there two times, won't it? Yeah, it will. That's a problem, right? So how are we going to do this? We then will enter in a reversing entry in order to reverse it. Another question you might have is you might say, well, why don't we just change the date on this thing to be before in March? And it's possible to do that. You could possibly do that in the system, but you don't typically want to do that kind of thing with your accounting process. You typically want to enter the invoice as you typically would enter the invoice and then have the audit trail making any kind of adjustment that would be necessary for it. So generally, you wouldn't want to, I mean, if you're doing an audit type of thing, you don't really want to delete the invoice or change the dates. Typically, I mean, again, in some cases you can do that, but that's not typically what you want to do. And it may be the case that it's already been paid or the invoice already went out. You want to check the terms of the invoice and make sure that you get a receipt payment on it and all that in the proper format. So we're not going to just change the date on the invoice. What we're going to do is do an adjusting entry to bring it back into the current time period. And then we'll have this problem of it being in there basically twice. And therefore, we will do a reversing entry making our books correct on an accrual basis as of the cutoff date, and then reversing it so that we're back to where we need to be, which is hopefully the way that the normal accounting process works best from a logistical standpoint. So next time we'll do the adjusting journal entry, and then after that at some point we'll do the reversing entry for it. That's it for now. Let's get out of here.